Hi friends, before going to start my session, I wanted to tell that if you are a teacher on that time, share this video with your students. If you are a student on that time, share with your friends. It is more helpful to them. Now I wanted to say that if you wanted the explanation in other languages, you can tell in the comment box. Now let's begin. Geography, class 10, chapter 3, Indian monsoon season and their features. Now let's see what is the meaning of monsoon. The word monsoon is derived from the Arabic word mausam. It means season. Now let's begin our session. India has tropical monsoon type of climate. In this type of climate, wind blows in the opposite direction in different season. In the different season, in our India has a tropical monsoon season, and that causes the wind blows in opposite direction to the opposite direction in different seasons. The half of the year the wind blows from the southwest to the northeast. In the half season, in 6 months, the wind blows in the southwest to the northeast, and remaining half they blow from the northeast to southwest. In remaining half a year, it blows northeast to southwest. In addition to the geographically, India is situated both in the tropical and temperate zone. The position of India distance from the sea direction of the wind. It lies in the tropical and temperate zone, and on that cause the position of our India distance from the sea, e direction of the wind, mountain range, ocean current, etc. The influence that climate condition of the country. Those features which are influenced our climatical conditions, those are the position of the sea in our India, and distance of the sea, the direction of the wind, mountain range, ocean current. Those are influence to the climatical condition of our country. Indian's climate is divided into four seasons. First one is a summer season. It was March to May. The second one is a southwestern monsoon season. It was June to September. Third one is a retreating monsoon season. It was October to November. Fourth one is a winter season. It was December to February. Now let's begin. Our first season is a summer season. The summer season begins from the first week of March and continues till the end of May. March is the third month of the year. On that time it was a begin, and later it will continue to the end of May. During this season, the sun rays are perpendicular and the northern hemisphere. Hence the temperature is high. Day are long. The North Indian plain are the way from the sea and have a very high temperature. In this season we see the days are long, and the North Indian plain are far away from the sea. He have a high temperature. The Rajasthan's Ganganagar record a maximum of 52 degrees Celsius in summer, and it is the hottest place of the country. Our India's hottest place is Ganganagar. Its temperature is 52 degrees Celsius in the summer days. Now let's move on. In contrast, the South India is surrounded by the water on three sides, and each temperature is moderate between the 32 degree to 35 degree Celsius. In our South India, it is covered with the sea, and that cause its temperature is moderate between the 32 degree Celsius to 35 degree Celsius. During this season, the North Indian mountain mountain range and the peninsula plateau are the cooler. In that time, the North Indian mountain range, which are lied in the north of our India, those are and the peninsula plateau, which are those are very cool. Due to the local temperature and wind, rainfall occurs at the same place during the April and May. Those areas rainfall occurs in the month of April and May. Those are called as a Kala Baisakhi. In the West Bengal, Andish. And Uttar Pradesh, coffee blue zones. In Karnataka, mango shower. In Kerala, during the summer, is the country receive only 10% of the annual rainfall. In the Karnataka, in the Kerala region, we see that the total average the annual rainfall of the whole over the country is only 10%. Let's move on. Our second monsoon type is the southwestern monsoon season. It is a rainy season. It is also called as a rainy season. In India, the southwestern monsoon comprises the rainy season. In our India, the southwestern monsoon season is called as a rainy season. Those are the humid and cause rainfall and most part of the country. In this period means the June to September, the most of the area is most of the area we see that the rainfall is occur in our country. This season is spread from the June to September. We see that already. This season was started from the June and ends from the September. 75% of the rainfall occurs during this season. In this season, we see the 75% of the rain was occurs in the southwestern monsoon season. The southwest monsoon season enter into India into the beaches. Southwestern monsoon season was entered in our India to the beaches. The Arabian Sea beach and the Bay of Bengal beach. Those two beaches are the main important beaches. Those are Arabian Sea and West Bengal. Bay of Bengal, through this southwestern monsoon was entered to our India. Monsoon wind are obstructed by the western ghats as such maximum rainfall occurs to the west of the ghats as the wind process to the east. In this area we see the western ghats region, it was occurs the high rainfall. Maximum rainfall was occurred in the area of Western Ghats. The maximum rainfall was occurred in the Western Ghats as the wind blows to the east, they get depleted to the eastern region. When the wind blows to the east, on that time they move to the eastern region. The Western Ghats is called as a rain shadow region. Which is called as a rain shadow region? The Western Ghats is called as a rain shadow region. The Bay of Bengal monsoon wind bring the rain to the Myanmar, Bangladesh, northeastern Indian region and foothills of Himalaya in the North Indian plains. Those areas which occur the rain in this region through the southwest monsoon season. Now let's move on. The rain reduces from the northeast and east to the northwest and exceptions of the Tamil Nadu region. The most of the part of the country receive the rain during the southwestern monsoon. We see that most of the areas which receive the rainfall in the southwestern monsoon season. Now let's move on. Our third type is a retreating monsoon. It started in October and ends in November. By the end of October, because of the wind spread, the southwestern monsoon rain, there is a decrease the temperature beside during the season. The sun rays fall vertically over the southern hemisphere. When the southwestern monsoon season was end, on that time the October, it was October, and the wind spreads to the southwestern monsoon rain, and that decreases the temperature because the sun rays fall vertical to the southern hemisphere. As a result, there is a drop in temperature in the northern hemisphere. Hence, this area became the area of high preserve and the southwestern monsoon. And the temperature of the northern hemisphere was became the area high pressure, and the southwestern monsoon winds started receding. These winds are stopped blowing by the end of the November. In the month of the November, the winds blowing was end. This is called as a rescending monsoon period. During this season, India received but 30% of the annual 13% of the annual rainfall. In this time, our India has received the 13% of the annual rainfall in this season. The tropical cyclone frequently occurs in the Bay of Bengal during this season. In this season, we see the tropical cyclones are occurred in the area of Bay of Bengal. They causes wind spread and damages along their path, and particularly along the eastern coast. Those are the wind spreads damages along their path, and particularly along with the eastern coast. Now let's move on. Our fourth season is winter season. In India, the winter season begins from the December and ends by the February. Winter season was started from the December and ends from the February. During this season, Jammu and Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh and North India plain witness a very low temperature. In our India, those areas like Jammu, Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, North India plain, receive the low temperature. In some places, the temperature drop sub-zero level and heavy snowfall occurs. In some region on the winter season, some areas are received the snowfall, heavy snowfall. But in the South India, the temperature is normal. In the South India, temperature is normal and climate is very pleasant. India received just about the 2% of annual rainfall during this season. In this season, in winter season, our India received the 2% of the annual rainfall in this season. Hence, the winter season is the season of least rainfall. In our four seasons, we see that the winter season is the lowest rainfall season in our India. Now let's move on. Distribution of the rainfall. Normally, India receive most of the annual rainfall from the southwestern monsoon. Our India received rainfall from the region of southwestern monsoon. There are a lot of variation in the intensity of rainfall. In our India's rainfall, we see the lot of intensity with regard to the area. India receive its rainfall during all the season. Our India received the rainfall in all the season. All the four seasons, the country's average rainfall is 118 centimeters. Our India's annual rainfall is 118 centimeter. However, different regions receive the rainfall during the different season. In our India, it was very differently. We see that our India has received the different regions receive the different times of rainfall. Beside total rainfall different from the one region, our India's total rainfall is different from the one area to another area. Based on the total quantum of the rainfall, India can be divided into three regions. To see those rainfalls, our India has divided into the three divisions. Now let's see which are those. First one is a low rainfall region. Second one is a moderate rainfall region. Third one is a heavy rainfall region. Now let's see, our first region is a low rainfall region. Here you are getting less than 50 centimeter of the rain are called as a area of deficit rainfall. Which area is getting 50 centimeters less than the 50 centimeters rainfall? Thus area is called as a deficit rainfall. Tihar desert of Rajasthan and the adjoining area like Punjab, Haryana, Kutch region of the region Jammu and Kashmir, eastern part of the Maharashtra and interior Karnataka are the areas of deficit rainfall. Those areas which are under the lower rainfall region. Raeli of Jaisalmer district. Raeli of the Jaisalmer district in the Rajasthan, it is receiving the least annual rainfall of 8.3 centimeter in the country. In whole over the country, it is Raeli of the Jaisalmer district in Rajasthan, it is received the lowest rainfall in our country. Now let's see our second part is moderate rainfall region. Area getting rainfall between the 50 to 250 centimeter is called as a area of moderate rainfall. The area of 50 to 250 centimeter receive the rainfall, it is called as a moderate rainfall. All area other than less and heavy rainfall comes under this region. All area which are covered in the less or the heavy rainfall comes under the moderate rainfall. Now let's see our third part is heavy rainfall region. The area receiving more than the 250 centimeter rainfall is called as a area of heavy rainfall. In which area we see the 250 centimeter of the heavy rainfall is called as a heavy rainfall region. In the western area and the western ghats, Assam and other eastern states and the West Bengal comes under this category. Now say those areas which comes under those areas means West Bengal, Assam and Western Ghats, those are comes under the category of a high rainfall. Mawasinaram in the Meghalaya gets the highest rainfall in the country. The climate condition of the country has great influence on the country economy. In our India, the climatical condition of the country, it was greatly influenced to the economy of our country. The southwestern monsoon control the agriculture of our India, which is the main occupation of our India. The agriculture of our India. The agriculture is a occupation of our India. It is not nowadays occupation. It is from the ancient time. Our Indian peoples are following this occupation. The failure of the rainfall leads to the drought and the monsoon are heavy, that is floods. They also causes for the destruction to the life and property. Hence it is said that Indian agriculture is a gambling with the monsoon. When the rainfall is in a high level, on that time we see the floods. In this year we see the many areas goes under the floods. Those like Assam, Bihar, those areas in our Maharashtra, Karnataka and in southern states also facing the floods. Those kind of things we have facing through the monsoon. And when the rain is not occur on that time also, we can face the problem like drought. Those are the problems. On that cause, we see the our Indian agriculture is called as a gambling with the monsoon. In today's session, we have studied about the Indian monsoon system. In that, Indian monsoon system and their features. In that, we have studied the summer season. Summer season, southwestern monsoon season, retreating monsoon season, winter season, and after that, we have seen the distribution of rainfall. In that, we see the three rainfall seasons like low rainfall region, moderate rainfall region, heavy rainfall region. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you all like this video. Don't forget to like and subscribe our channel.